Welcome back to Let's Play Grandia Redux. Just so you know, I went back and basically played through what I did in the last part again. Just to get Fina her hot whip back. Also, I bought a frog axe for Justin. There is an axe I can buy in Dite. It's a little bit more expensive, but it gives out like 15 more attack. But the reason I didn't want that, one, money reasons, I didn't really feel like selling anymore, and negative 10 defense, which if I put on him, we'll have the same defense as Fina, and I don't really care to do that. Also, a little something to show you if you don't know about this. When someone leaves your party permanently, it sneaks items into your stash. One, everything they had equipped, so me playing with Sue's equipment was pointless. And something that's a little bit nicer. Sue's mace experience plus 1/3. Basically what that does, let's say Sue had 9 levels in maces. She was a lot higher, but that's beside the point. I use it on Justin, he gets 3 levels. 300 experience, that's what it does. I'm gonna save these for quite a while. Mostly because of, you know, just that oh crap, I need a little bit of a boost. But other than that, everything's pretty much the same. I didn't really play with anything else. She's not in the party. Fina's got her whip back. I bought 2 thief cutters like I did before. Basically, everything's pretty much the same. Nothing really changed all that much. Just, you know, I did that last part over again, basically, to get the whip back. Because I'm like, I don't really want to do that, because having the thief cutter is nice, but having only the thief cutter would kind of suck, because that would wreak havoc with my inventory. Do I want to get rid of anything before I continue on? No, I don't think so. Hello, Dr. Alma. So what you're saying is we're probably going to take bad care of it, and it needs to be tough, right? Is that what you're saying? I think I'm good. I mean, granted, I could go somewhere with the thief cutter and probably farm up like a bajillion chalas, but that sounds really boring. Anyway, this is Gadwin's boat, which looks kind of awesome if they would rotate the camera back to where we can see it. Kind of looks a little bit like a, one of those anglerfish, the ones that live really, really deep sea, which is probably the, look they were trying to give to it. That's my assumption. Bye, Dite. We shall not see you again for the rest of this game. I can play again and see it, but, my guess is Fina's driving the boat. Justin's probably like, I don't know what to do. And, well, Fina is awesome. Fina's enjoying the night air out at sea. That lovely ocean smell when it's not low tide. Yeah, low tide smell. Ugh. And Justin, of course, is out to cold, sleeping on his hat. She's just kind of relaxing outside, dear. Save point. Yay, it has recovered. Thank you. Don't really need to play with stash point. Let's go out and, talk to Fina. See what she's up to. Hello, Fina.
Oh, Justin. You're awake. Look. Everywhere you look, there's nothing but ocean. Not a single island in sight. The moon is so beautiful. See its reflection in the sea sparkling like a diamond? Say, Justin. Are you planning on standing there forever? Come sit with me.
It depends on what you do. We'll change what she says slightly. It doesn't really matter, though. It's basically the same.
Why are you sitting so far away? Fine. I'll move over there. This is the first time we've been alone together. What's wrong? Why the silent treatment?
Well, you know.
You know, I've been thinking about things here in the night breeze. Say, you know what I've been thinking about? Guess, Justin.
I know. You've been thinking about me. That Justin, he's so manly, so handsome, and such a wonderful person. Guess not, huh?
Try again.
I know.
Well, maybe you weren't entirely wrong.
Huh?
When I first met you, Justin, we were sailing over the sea. I'm remembering that time.
That time? You said I was still a newbie, and you wouldn't even give me the adventurer's greeting.
At that time, I never even imagined that I'd go on a journey with you. But you've grown stronger and braver and so trustworthy, Justin. Your place in my heart grows bigger and bigger.
Thena?
Long ago, when I was still living with my big sister, I was so happy. But the day my sister left, I was all alone. Even now, I sometimes worry. The more I think I'm happy, the more I worry. I worry that everyone will leave me, and that I'll be left all alone again sometime. Justin, do you think we can be together forever?
Of course we will. We're gonna have adventures together forever.
That makes me so happy. Thank you, Justin. When I'm with you, Justin, I feel so safe. And just so happy. It's because I'm with you, Justin. No one else. Not even my sister could take your place.
Thena.
Say, Justin, do you love me?
Well, that came out of the boonies. Sheesh.
Of course I love you. Sue loves you, and Gadwin too. We all love you, Thena.
Justin, I'm not talking about that kind of love.
Huh? Thena, what do you mean? Thena. It must be because of the moonlight. You look different than usual. I mean, well, you look really beautiful. Well, of course, you're always pretty. What am I saying? It's strange.
Isn't it odd? I can say things now that I'd normally be too embarrassed to say.
Thena.
Justin. You're special to me.
What was that? That sound?
What's wrong? Did something hit us?
Kind of just ruined that moment, but yay, awkward young love. Wow. The pirates? Really? Back away. He's my man. Get away. Just randomly? Justin, you're getting in trouble again. Oh, jealousy. She's understandably, you know, kind of peeved off. But apparently there are pirates. Ah, this place. Now, among everywhere in this game, I have to say without a map, this place is the most confusing of them all, simply because everything looks the same. And we know how Fina's hunches are. They're usually right. Yeah, either way, we should check it out. Anyway, I need to get the map. Otherwise, I'm gonna get lost, and nobody wants that. Well, somebody might who gets sick pleasure out of watching me wander around aimlessly, but I don't want to do it. But yeah, either way, this place, as confusing as it is, isn't really all that huge. But, yeah, okay. Just making sure, might need that for cover. This place being what it is, out in the ocean and blah blah blah, you can pretty much expect things to be relatively weak versus fire. Could you come here, please, so I could show you? Come here, please. Rumble. Where am I on this map, anyway? Aha! There I am. Kind of, yeah. It's the whole everything looks the same, so it's difficult to find your way around and all that. Anyway, at least I get to show one of the new enemies. I don't get to play with the other ones because they're like, nah, I don't feel like fighting you. Toad King! With 660 HP, which is... Yeah, I guess it's really not that... Well, it might be considered a lot considering there's only two of us, but eh. I'm just going to slap him around a while, see if they do anything. That's exactly why I wanted the explosive whip back. Because even with the huge difference between their strength, Fina's still doing almost as much damage to Justin. That's really not all that much. Probably hit them pretty hard with the fire whip.
You'll never get away.
Luckily, the save point in the ship still has recover. Well, it really wouldn't be right. Well, it'd be pretty mean if he kicked that out, since there's no other save point in this area. Stop that. Yeah, Justin's in for what, 190, 160? The 190 was a counter. So, yeah, might be getting some whip levels here. Take care of that dude. And, yeah, the one defending. At least if they're defending, you can get a good chunk of, experience out of them, since you're doing less damage and they're not really doing anything.
Not bad, eh?
That sounds a little bit loud. Vaccine, apparently they probably deal plague, which, they try to do that. I'm gonna stop that immediately. That's not a whole hell of a lot of weapon experience, either. Although Fina's close to leveling, that's quite nice. I can deal with that. I don't think there's anything that way, no. Some gold. The boss of this area is honestly a jerk. Ooh. Excuse me. More toads, which I will kill off screen. Yeah, those frogs definitely do plague. Fina got hit with it by like 30 times, and yeah, well, not 30. You understand what I'm trying to say. Wind, earth, They're a little bit strong to Earth. It doesn't do a whole lot of damage, but I believe their Earth resistance is about the same as their fire resistance. So, I can work on that as well. You know what? I've actually, except for water, which, you know, I'm healing a lot, her skills are relatively even. Except for, yeah, the weapons are a little bit higher, but those tend to be a little bit easier to level, especially when you don't need to worry about wasting MP. Since physical attacks are pretty much free. Anyway, a rain weed, which I have no idea what it does. 100 HP to one friend. That's actually pretty useful. I mean, it's not like a spirit herb, which is 500, but that's a little bit much, really. Don't really need to worry about a huge heal like that. And there's some gold over there, but I need to show these first. Hippo camps, which, yeah. Hippo camps have a fire and earth resistance problem. I think it is probably a little higher than it was in the original game, meaning the explosive whip Fina has will do lots of damage. Or not. And I just lied to you. Damage, still not that high, but there's only two of us. I just want to see how plain fire works. I don't need to really wait for her to get the skill off either, so. It's just kind of point and shoot. Yeah, see, fire works fine, explosive, not so much, but I guess the combined resistance works a little bit different, and you got dodgified! Yay! Strong versus wind, strong versus water, so crackle probably works like crap. No. I didn't want to do that. I wanted to use tremor. Oops. Wasting MP. Only single hits, but you know, it's the whole only got two people. There's no chance of picking up another one, so it has to be kind of nice versus you. I mean, if he made it so that they had multiple hits and blah blah blah, but didn't hit hard, he'd probably still die because of IP stun. So it makes sense to have them hit decently, not too hard, and only really hits once. Of course, you know, there's the status ailment thing that you gotta worry about. Pretty sure that everything here has at least something that's unagreeable. Then again, anything that really hits you in this game is unagreeable from the character's viewpoint. Anyway, let's grab this gold, and next time, I will do more of this area. Probably going to clear out the whole thing, hit up the save point in the ship, and then go fight the boss of this area. Which, as I remember, is a big pain in the butt. But yes, until then.